guys, we are back. It's the AMAs, and we're talking fashion.
That's right. We have got the best dressed on the red carpet. This is Dirty Laundry.
Ugh, Taylor Swift. I know. Taylor Swift elevates the word perfection. Like, perfection gets better every time Taylor Swift steps on a red carpet.
Gosh, Taylor Swift, every single time she steps on a red carpet, I get chills on my body. Tonight was no exception.
She looks amazing. I can't handle this.
I only have one thing to say.
What?
You're so gorgeous. I can't say anything to your face. Because look at that face.
So good.
Immediately, my first thought was that she looks like a disco ball. If I were to try to wear that, I'd look like one of those reflectors you put in your car so it doesn't get too hot in the summer.
I get disco ball vibes. You could probably see stuff if you get close enough. I think Taylor Swift always looks good on carpets. Her stylist just knows what they're doing. Mm-hmm. This is everything. I love that the boots match the dress.
Oh, I know, like perfectly. Like that is a set.
Also, women have to bring a mirror with them on a red carpet. And she was like, I don't need a mirror. I will be my mirror.
She had a blank space and she filled it. This is custom Balmain. I love the matching boots. And I personally think this is one of my favorite Taylor Swift red carpet looks. Because I know Taylor likes to go feminine a lot of the time. She wears like a lot of tulle and like flowers and like pastel colors.
Right.
So I like to see Taylor be like edgy.
Here's the thing. Taylor never does anything on accident, right? Like everything has some huge meaning. She's the disco ball. The disco ball. Where does the disco ball go?
On the ceiling?
The center of the party. It is the one that is like, it is the thing at a party that's responsible for getting the mood started,
yes.
Getting the lighting going. She is literally bringing that to the AMAs.
She refracts?
She refracts
the lurch.
This outfit is what in the 90s we thought the future was gonna look like, and it does.
Exactly.
Because she wore it.
Exactly.
She proved it true.
Oh, Camila Cabello.
Camila Cabello. I'm not crazy about it.
I'm bored.
I'm sorry.
Man, I'm so underwhelmed. I almost fell asleep. I almost fell asleep.
It's like she took a list of everything that would look tacky in the color black and then put it on.
It looks like
black.
Her friend invited her out and she just put something together as opposed to got ready and styled for the AMAs.
Maybe she just wanted to go for a simpler, more mature, subdued look.
I love her so much, so much. And I would still probably kill 10 people to look like her in this photo.
I thought you were gonna say kiss her.
I would definitely make out with her. But this outfit, you guys, is so boring. It looks like something my mom would wear on a night out with her girlfriends.
Oh my gosh, can't wait to hang out with your mom. Let me just throw that out there. Here's the thing, Camila, she doesn't do anything on accident either. She's just like Taylor Swift, her mentor. This outfit is telling me I don't even need to care about what I'm wearing because I'm already slaying the game. I could show up in a burlap sack and still make the best dress list.
You're like an infomercial for celebrity fashion.
I really am.
The top is just so like prom 2000s and I feel like it doesn't fit her perfectly, and the shoes could have been like a different color to like pop, maybe match the jewels. Again, Camila looks sexy. I don't like this outfit.
I mean, I guess you're entitled to your opinion.
She looks like a limo driver.
I guess my first question would be why all black? Like even her hair. It's black now. It's not even dark brown. I think she dyed her hair black.
Well, I usually like all black looks. Like, I'm okay with that, but this one is just not, there's nothing special about it. And if you're gonna go to the American Music Awards,
you gotta go all out, you know?
Special.
Here's the thing about the American Music Awards red carpet.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't have its own style. It is a blank slate. So you get to show up in whatever your style is. Instead of dressing up for the awards, mm-hmm. you dressed up for yourself.
Yeah, but Camila can do better. We've seen her in better.
Oh my gosh, Cardi B!
Oh my gosh, you scared me so badly.
I'm a little frightened, but in a good way, by this outfit.
Cardi is literal Chiquita Banana. Like, she's giving me all the vibes.
Yeah.
I like it, I like it, I like it like that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, it does kind of have that, like, Chiquita Banana kind of feel with, like, being so texturized. But this, I wonder what she smells like.
Her bosom is so beautiful.
I love this, Renee. I love this. Cardi B did that.
I'm shook. I love this.
She looks phenomenal.
She looks like a garden party I want an invitation to.
I love the Latin floral, beautiful vibes of this. It reminds me of her single.
This kind of reminds me of Beyonce's photo wall of when she had her babies.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly. She is the saying, I am Beyonce's photo wall.
Yeah.
I especially love that it's obviously a very like big flowy dress, but that corset on top is so hot.
So hot, and it makes her boobs look amazing. Her face looks beautiful.
I mean, the AMAs, anything can go on the red carpet, honestly. I know I didn't love Camila's outfit, but honestly, she can get away with it because it's the AMAs. There's no pomp and circumstance. It's kind of like the VMAs that way, but I think not quite as crazy. But you know what? Cardi B can do whatever she wants.
I mean,
people are gonna love it.
Erin, this event is literally presented by YouTube Music. That means people could show up dressed like us and it would be okay.
No, let's not go that far.
Okay. Oh my gosh, this is some drama. Ooh. The tea is hot, Erin.
What is the tea?
Halsey and G-Eazy showed up to the American Music Awards after she called him a pumpkin eater, which you know what that means.
Cheater, pumpkin eater. Oh, I'm so glad you said that, not something dirty. I was like, is that dirty?
G-Eazy and Halsey are back together. Like, what an emotional roller coaster this summer, you guys. Thank you for coming back, coming strong, showing us that love is real.
And they look great.
But thanks for also showing us that the Goodwill clearance rack is not a place you should probably get your dress for the AMAs.
I love the pixie cut. I love the pink. I think he's a beautiful man.
That's an understatement. But what's really interesting about his outfit, it is really hard as guys to wear something on the carpet that looks cool and stylish and edgy. And I think this is a sexy man outfit.
Halsey's makeup and her face and her hair color are bomb. The woman is stunning.
Yeah, she's beautiful.
But this looks like a bad fabric at Mood.
I think she looks like she doesn't know what to do in a dress. Like, a dress is not her natural attire. Like, her natural attire is probably like a little sports bra and some hip hop pants.
I have a question for you. If you were given the choice, would you wear Halsey's outfit or G-Eazy's outfit?
No, I actually think I'd wear G-Eazy's outfit.
Same, 100%.
I mean, I'd maybe get the pants a little bit tighter, but everything else I'm into.
I don't know, I feel like it's very breathable in the crotchal region. I really like what he's working with.
Liza Koshy, brown girl magic.
How, Liza Koshy? She looks different, right?
She looks very mature.
Yeah.
She looks like an adult.
I love this ponytail on Liza Koshy. Like, I love this long, long pony. It reminds me of like the red Jasmine in Aladdin. Remember when Jafar like had her under his spell?
I do remember that.
That's the vibe I'm
getting.
Very
specific reference that was.
I'm obsessed with her ponytail. It's not like I'm biased, because like I love a good ponytail, but her ponytail.
Wow, Renee.
I just think ponytails are so in right now. Like, I just think they're really trendy.
They are.
Let's address the fact that it's wide leg pants with the peplum top. She has a body. I cannot see it in this outfit.
I agree.
It's like she's wearing a curtain around her.
It's a lot of fabric for Liza Koshy's figure. But I do love that she is being sexy with her shoulder.
It looks like something that was like like she went into her closet and found something old and then she made it into something new and now it's this. And I really like it.
It's good. This is good, girl.
Big fan.
Shawn Mendes looks like such a little happy camper of a babe.
He looks like this in every carpet.
He really does.
If you could cut him out, like, is this the cardboard cutout of Shawn Mendes at the last red carpet that he attended?
Cut and pasted his head on an Express model's body.
And his outfit. He wears the same outfit. I mean, it's a great outfit. I think if you've got something good, don't break it.
Don't change something if it's not broken.
Don't break something if it ain't broken.
Don't fix it. I will say, Sean, I love your shoes.
That is such a specific thought.
Look at how cool they are. They're like maroonish.
Of all the things to talk about,
his hand tattoo is popping.
He looks so fine, but like, when does he not?
Yeah, he always looks good. He looks dapper.
I love his hair. I don't know if that's what his hair always looks like. I don't really pay enough attention to guys' hairs, because I don't...
It looks very coiffed, right? Hairs.
Yeah.
All the hairs, plural, on his head look very nice. Yes, I agree.
But there's like that one curl that's like out of place, but it's probably on purpose.
Like Superman Clark Kent, right?
How hot are the boys of NCT 127?
So hot. This is why every man should have a tuxedo.
Seriously, like, bring back the tux.
Men just look so good in a tux. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, the 1950s called, and they said that we need the tuxes of them now.
On every guy now. I love like the bigger bow. They just look all so well, and they're so well groomed.
Also, the differences in their personal grooming and style pops because they are dressed identical.
They look very dapper.
Yeah, they do. I think it's really hard when there's so many of you in one group to all be ready for the photo.
It looks like they're about to break out into song and choreographed dance.
That's exactly what it looks like. I'm a big fan of their matching attire, and they're just, it's classic.
It's very classic. It's the definition of classic, actually.
Stop. I don't know what to do with what J-Lo serves up to me.
Perfect. This looks like a Hollywood version of a pageant dress. Back when I was doing pageants,
yes,
people would wear dresses like this on stage, and I understand why. It's so freaking gorgeous.
And her leg is just so toned and tanned and fabulous, and the fierce look on her face.
And the hair. The hair is so messy and beautiful at the same time. How do celebrities do that? I don't understand.
I think she went to the beach right before and just like let the wind blow through her hair and then showed up.
Ugh.
First of all, I love that she came in pink. Like such a great neon, like colors are actually really in this
She's
fall.
She's not trying to blend in. She looks amazing. The bronziness of this Puerto Rican woman just pops with this pink dress. The dress exposes all her best assets, even though they're all equally great. Like she is evenly distributed in great genetics.
Her hair looks incredible. Like I love the bangs swooped to the side, the messy bun in the back.
And she's serving looks. She's like,
she is serving so much more than looks. Lauren Jauregui. So purple is definitely like a color on the carpet.
It's like her and Halsey coordinated this.
Yeah, her and Halsey should take a picture together. I like this. This is giving me...
You do like this.
I do like it. It's giving me, like, October Halloween vibes, like Mrs. Adams meets... What did Angelina Jolie play?
In what?
Maleficent.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You don't like it?
I don't love it. Again, I can't see her body. I don't love pattern. I like solid color.
Okay.
I don't, my eye can't understand this. It's like a tie-dye dress, and I just don't believe in a tie-dye couture gown.
Yeah.
Lauren in Thai Dolla Sign looked so good on this carpet. I think, and I could be wrong, was this their first carpet they walked together?
Oh, I'm not sure. Is it?
Because they looked super cute. And I saw them holding each other's hands, and looking adorable, and just like regular couple stuff. I like that he's going for the all black look, and she has the all black with a bunch of purple in it, so they do match.
Mm-hmm. They're very good looking people. I really like his shoes.
Oh my God, I love his shoes.
Yeah, and the dress is dope. Like, I would normally wear a dress like that, but it looks really good on her. Because I think, it looked very Halloween vibes. I don't know if it's because of October and I'm just feeling Halloween today, but it's like Halloween, like witchy vibes, you know?
Oh, I totally get the witchy vibes. Mm-hmm. Also, I feel like this is such a Lauren dress.
Yeah.
From what we've seen in Lauren in the past, this doesn't surprise me. I think her stylist knows her real well. And I also, I think I see a little bit of purple eyeshadow to go with the dress, and I'm into it.
I put a spell on you.
Ooh, the Hudge is such a vision, such a goddess of years gone by.
What's so unique about this is that it's so understated for such an event as the AMAs. You would think that she would go in color or something big or flashy, but this is so simple and so pretty. I want to wear this to like my prom circa 80 years ago.
She looks absolutely fantastic. I love that she's such a chameleon too, because she's constantly trying out different trends. She's not scared of trends. And this is like safe, but also unexpected for her.
She looks beautiful.
She really does. This is such an elegant look on her, and I love that it's just a little blush pink.
She's looking like an elegant bottle of Pepto-Bismol. You better go ahead, girl. Look at her haircut. I love that.
It's so structured.
It's like, this is like a very like old school look. I think it's the 60s I'm thinking of. I think it's the hair. But the dress is just so soft and simple and beautiful. Wow.
All right, Erin, who was your best dressed?
Well, you know, I have to say Liza Koshy because, I mean, I didn't get to talk about her very much in this episode, but my heart very much is connected to her outfit. Mm-hmm. It is so comfortable. It is pants. It's still colorful and edgy, but not too far. I mean, she could do no wrong ever in my book, so Liza Koshy.
I know where I'm being drawn to. I have to talk about the disco queen, the disco ball herself, the woman to whom the whole party circulates around, Taylor Swift. Honestly, because I think she cast a spell on me.
Same. I think she's cast a spell on the world.
Yeah.
Okay, Miriam, my favorite was Cardi B, hands down. Oh, like, she has just been killing the fashion game. And who can you guys picture in this outfit? Like, no one else can pull it off the way that she can.
True.
And she looks stunning.
Okay, I've narrowed it down to Taylor, J-Lo, Cardi, and from there, I guess, J-Lo, Cardi, and from there, Cardi.
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 Cardi. Cardi.
Cardi. Cardi.
My favorite of the night was Taylor Swift. Shocked. Because she
she
looked stunning tonight.
She did.
This was my favorite carpet look of hers, maybe ever. And that's a bold statement.
Wow.
She's had some good looks, but I really liked it. I loved that it was the perfect amount of fun and edgy and gorgeous. And obviously I'm like a huge Swiftie, but what about you, Drew?
My favorite was Cardi B, hands down. Cardi, you made me want fruit real bad. Even though it was floral.
Well, you guys, that does it for this episode of Dirty Laundry, where we're just breaking down all the best and worst looks on the carpet. But honestly, what do we know?
I'm exhausted talking about fashion. You guys get to talking yourselves in the comments. Let us know who your favorite, best, and worst dress was. And subscribe to our channel, because we do this every single award show.
It's pretty awesome. You're gonna love it. Bye.
Thank you guys so much for watching. And for more clever, you better click in this box right here. And also, there's a box that says subscribe, and it's down there for a reason, because we want you to subscribe.